Hi, it's Larry here from Xbox Live's Major Nelson, podcast number 630.
Hola.
Hello, Jeffrey. Hola, Jeffrey. ¿Cómo está usted?
Bien.
Yeah, thank you, dude. We're just fresh back from our journey down to Mexico City, which was, we'll tell you about that story in a little bit.
Oh, there's many stories.
There are.
So many stories.
There are. Great episode of Inside Xbox. We got to see Jeff talk Kingdom Hearts.
You know me. I love the Japanese games. I love the Square Enix. I love getting to meet Hashimoto-san.
Yeah, that was fun.
Getting in a selfie with him.
Yeah, that was. I was at the other end of this. I was getting ready for my cut in, and I looked over and like, what is going on over there? And you were getting everybody revved up and doing selfies.
I got back, backstage, and I grabbed my phone, and there was like double digit amounts of text messages going. You know,
right.
What was that?
Right.
It was pretty cool.
Anyway, so welcome back. We're just sitting here. We're recording this. We're just a little bit, just about a week shy of the United States holiday, which is called Thanksgiving.
Oh, tell me more about this.
Well, we sit around and eat more food.
So much food.
So much food. It's Thanksgiving. It's turkey.
I got to pre-order my turkey. You don't just pre-order video games anymore. You got to pre-order the turkey,
Jeffrey,
Larry.
We talked about this last week. A week ago, we talked
and
about
this. I
haven't
this. Done it yet.
And I even went to the website for the local supermarket. I'm
you
like,
did.
Which one? How much is it? And here you go.
I only locked my guest list yesterday.
How many?
An even dozen.
Okay, so 12. To 12.
12. So what is it? Like, how many? Do you get a pound of turkey per person?
Sure.
Okay. A 12 pound turkey. Is that a lot?
Let's, you know, it doesn't feel like a lot. Let's go 2 pounds per person.
There we go.
Let's go an even 30.
Because the turkeys I'm killing in Red Dead, they look like they're a little on the small side.
Well, they are. And, you know, I'm playing that entire game underweight, I noticed.
I am too.
I don't know what to
I'm
do.
I'm not eating enough.
I've never been more fit.
One oat cake per day. Is that an unhealthy diet?
No, wait a minute. You're supposed to be feeding the oat cakes to your horse, which your horse's name is it Trigger?
It was Glue Stick.
I had an
issue with Glue Stick last night.
What happened?
So we were going through the bayou,
mm-hmm.
And I saw on the map there was a place I could buy some bait. And I'm starting to get into
shop.
The fishing, a bait shop.
Yep.
And so I went through the area. When you get into the bayou, like early on in the game, you can just cut through. You don't need to stay on the roads. Once you get into the bayou, there be gators.
Yes, there be large gators.
Large gators.
And you are no stranger to the bayou. Well, not necessarily swampland and gators.
I've been within 5 feet of a gator many times. They, you just, you know,
you get side eye
from
a gator.
Stay away from the nest. You do. That's all they have is side eye. That's all they have.
That's true.
So, anyways, I go around and I go to the bait shop, and as I'm going back to my camp, I was ambushed by some bounty hunters. And I was like, well, I could surrender.
Watch the spoilers.
But, well, look, at times you're going to be apprehended by Johnny Law.
Yeah.
And I fought the law.
And the law won.
The law won.
Oh, no.
And right before they killed me, they had taken down my horse. And I saw, like, the prompt come up, do I want to use a horse reviver?
Yes.
I always carry horses.
Yes.
But I was in the middle of a gunfight.
And you couldn't.
You know, and it was sort of, you know, this happens in
Gloostick was
Destiny
on, Gloostick
or anything
was
like
down.
That. Gloostick was down.
Oh, no.
And within 3 seconds, I was dead too. And when I got resurrected,
no,
$150 lighter, by right. the way, I was like, that's not my horse.
Right.
That was just
that
some
was
jobber horse.
It was a rental.
Yeah, that was... That was like the Nissan Altima
right.
of horses, you
the
know, like whatever
burns.
Rental car, you know, like had like 10,000 miles on it, and that's just not my horse. So I was a little distraught,
yeah.
And then immediately the next mission I did, I had to like keep up the pace, and this
you couldn't do.
I
it.
Didn't have, I did not have a bond with this horse.
Did
I didn't
so? Did you go back to the stable? So we're talking about Red Dead Redemption on Red Dead Redemption 2 on Xbox One X.
We're
simply
all playing
looks
it.
Phenomenal.
Oh, that's so good.
But did you go back to the stable later to see if the horse would reappear?
Oh, is that something that can happen?
Yeah. So I had a problem where I lost my horse's name is Apple Pie.
Oh.
And I, by the way,
right, like PI, like the
maybe
like the what's that little chip you have that you, oh, it's Raspberry Pi.
That's Raspberry
where you
Pi.
Can do the programming.
Right. But no, it's Apple Pie. And then I got the Arabian horse finally, and I named it Whipped Cream.
Oh,
because it's white.
I see. So you're sort of going on the Android OS.
Well,
method.
No, I'm actually culinary, full on culinary.
Okay.
Anyway, and I lost Apple Pie, and I was really bummed.
I'd be
I was really
as well.
Bummed. So I went back to the stable and like switched to one horse, and then came back, and Apple Pie was there. So I was like, he had returned.
He has risen.
So you may want to try that.
I'm gonna have to look. If not, I will have to figure out a way to get Glue Stick 2.
Yeah,
Electric Boogaloo.
glue stick too, more glue.
I felt a keen sense of loss. Like, yeah. Like, you know what I did? And I saved after I finished that mission.
Did you go to bed?
And like, I played a different game.
Yeah, you're like, you were.
I needed
you were
to come back. I needed. And then, you know what? So I was playing Assassins. I hadn't played Assassins in a few weeks. And just like comparing the horse mechanic, it's just a completely different game.
Yeah, you push down to whistle
you
on
do,
that one.
And I kept doing it.
Right, right.
And then I was like going off to Icaros, my hawk.
Right,
you're up
like,
there.
No.
So I'm one of these people who, and I think it's probably not just me, but jumping back and forth from game to game, it's a good reason to finish a game before starting another one.
Right, right.
But
right.
I don't have that level.
You know, you can
of,
use your Elite controller and remap that.
I could.
So that you're up and down.
Once you start making up is down.
I know.
Wait, I'm an in.
You're an inverse.
But this was, you were really picking on me here. It took me a second.
Red Dead.
Happy birthday, Larry.
Well, not happy birthday to me. Happy birthday to Xbox.
Xbox, the OG Xbox.
This past week, we celebrated 17 years.
Can you believe it? Were you here when the original Xbox launched?
I was not on the Xbox team. I was working at Microsoft. I had started working at Microsoft in right before that, and I was working on a product the next hallway over from where Xbox was. And I remember we'd always have these meetings and the Xbox guys and girls were going into a meeting. We were coming out of a meeting. I'm like, what are you guys working on? And I struck up some friendship with some folks over there. And that's how I ended up working over on Xbox is I was like, oh, you're working on NFL Fever? Tell me about that. Ooh. I'd like to play that. And they're working on it. Anyway, so I did not, but I was pretty darn, I was definitely within the orbit and the atmosphere.
I feel like a little bit of Major Nelson rubbed off. You weren't even referred to as Major Nelson
that's right.
back then.
That's before,
you were just Larry.
That's right.
You were just Larry in accounting.
Before Major Nelson, before Crazy Larry, before all that.
Man. The Xbox was here before all of us.
I know you're going to find this article. It was before YouTube, before Twitch, before Mixer, before Facebook, before Twitter, before MySpace.
Was it before MySpace? 2001.
Right.
Yeah, social networking didn't really exist.
Nope. It was right after Windows XP launched.
Yeah.
So
I remember the last OS I bought in a box.
That's right.
Windows XP.
That's right. So
amazing.
Anyway,
17 years.
17 years, and it's been incredible. And Jeff and I have had the wonderful opportunity of looking up the pipeline and seeing the future. There's some good stuff coming, aren't there?
You gonna put me up to that?
You have
better pipe sight lines than I do.
Well, I'm always looking to get into that sensational headline on some.
That's what it is. You haven't been quoted in a while.
I haven't been quoted in a while. I'm craving a quote. Anyway, so yeah, happy birthday. Happy birthday.
So Yeah, I've got eyes everywhere. Little birds, as they say.
Yeah.
And little birds told me you had a special guest up here this week.
Did I have a special guest
here? You did have a from Burbank. A good friend.
I did. That is absolutely right. A very good friend of mine, somebody who I just adore, is Mr. Ted Price.
One of the nicest guys in the industry.
CEO of Insomniac Games.
And you brought him up here to talk about Spyro, right?
Yeah. Well, no.
Well, that was his game.
Well, that was his game.
Second game ever.
But we were talking about Sunset Overdrive, now available on Windows 10 and the Windows 10 store and Steam.
Have you tried it yet on PC?
I have not. I have absolutely not.
I did. I actually went back
you
through
did?
And they... You know, one of the benefits of working here, I got to test it out
That's the only benefit, right? Nothing else.
Well,
it's not the free beverages.
I am staring down the barrel of some seltzer water right now.
The complimentary well-lit parking.
It's, hey, when you've worked in like a wet, dark parking
right.
lot, you know, like it
makes a difference.
It helps. But yeah, one of the cool things. So I got to try it out and I had forgotten just how much I love that character creator.
Right.
Like you can make a character that you just really fall in love with. And,
right.
And I did. I think I ended up making probably the exact same character. But it's cool playing through it again. And, you know, I can bring it with me on my laptop. And, you know, when I'm going on vacation this winter.
Right.
Probably a good chance I'm going to be playing through Sunset again.
Well, yeah, but you're gonna be on holiday. Have we talked about your holiday? Do you want to talk about that at all?
Well.
You're doing another international jaunt.
Yeah. I mean, we've talked about it before that. We travel so much for work.
Yeah, we do.
And we have once things start ramping up and we start getting ready for E3, that's pretty much it. You're working straight through the rest of the year until Thanksgiving. And, you know, maybe you get the weekends off, but.
We don't.
Not this last weekend. We were in Mexico. Not that we're complaining because it's amazing, but I tend to take a big trip around Christmas. The whole family gets together and we go somewhere and we are going to be going down to New Zealand. It was just someplace we wanted to go. I had never been, so gonna do it.
Good for you.
And I'm gonna definitely be gaming. I'm already getting gonna have my laptop. I'm gonna have my Switch. Let's go Pikachu or Eevee. I gotta make that decision.
And then what?
And then what? Yeah. And Diablo?
And Diablo, exactly.
Yeah. So it's gonna be good. It's gonna be good. What about you? Are you going anywhere?
Let's see. Thanksgiving, I'll be around here. Back for Christmas, I'm gonna go back to New England. I'm gonna go see my family back there. So I'll be bouncing around. I think I may have an event or two planned, like I often do over the holidays.
Yeah, you love to visit. There's about four stores within a driving distance there?
For the most part, yeah. We'll find something.
You might have a white Christmas.
I think it's happening now. So.
Oh yeah, this is. I saw hashtag first snow, and there was a lot of right. Philly. Philly, it doesn't snow that often, especially not in November. So that's pretty cool.
Yeah, there's a lot going on. So yeah, so those are my travel plans. But let's talk about you know, we talked about what we're playing, Red Dead, and that's really consuming a lot of my time. Fallout 76. Starting that to do. I've got some Battlefield in queue.
We got to play some Battlefield.
Yeah. Okay.
I'm hearing it looks really good.
Yeah,
I downloaded it via EA Access, yes, which gets you access to the first 10 hours, or I think the first chapter, and then maybe, you know, you can fill the rest of that hour in multiplayer. Great. But yeah, that's what I've heard. I got a couple notes back saying this looks really good.
We had a chance to go down to Mexico, Jeff and I.
It was amazing.
We were down there for FanFest. On behalf of everybody here at Xbox, I want to thank everybody in Mexico who came out and joined us.
Thousands and thousands of amigos.
If you could not join us, then we're sorry, but it was a wonderful time. We did Inside Xbox, which everyone, I was looking online, I'm sure you saw the same thing, Jeff, I'm like, why are these people clapping so much? The Mexican audience, the folks down there in Mexico City, are just lovely, and they're just really excited.
There are some of the, and I don't want to pit one country against another, but if there is a more enthusiastic bunch of Xbox fans, I don't know that I've met them.
Yeah.
We felt like we were getting a, you know, an honored welcome.
Yeah.
And everyone's just so nice, you know, giving us recommendations. And I love Mexico. I've never been outside of Mexico City in Mexico.
Nor have I.
But it is a really cool place, and I do recommend you visit.
We had a great show. It was a long show. It was a couple hours, but
we had a ton to announce.
And I'm sure you've got, I don't know if you want to go through those announcements.
We can do it. I have it ready to go.
Quick little recap.
If you
and then
somehow missed
Feel free to sprinkle in some of the stories, because there were stories.
Oh, there's always stories, Larry.
Go ahead.
I want to say, what was the first thing that we talked about? Well, actually, why don't we just start from the top news,
yes,
which actually came last. You got to do an announcement with head of Microsoft Studios, Matt Booty.
Oh, that was the end. That was the end of the show. We're going to work backwards, like from the bottom of the show back.
Well, I mean, there was a lot, but I think that's one big place to start.
Yeah, Matt Booty and I were on stage at the end, kind of bringing up the rear, talking about expanding the Microsoft family of studios to 13.
13, and the new additions were,
yes,
Obsidian Entertainment.
Yes.
Now, you might know these folks from Fallout New Vegas.
Yep.
You might know them from Alpha Protocol. You might know them from KOTOR.
Yep.
Ton of great games, Western RPG creators,
yep,
and so very cool that we're going to get to work alongside them. The other one, again, RPG creators, In Exile Entertainment,
mm-hmm,
has joined Microsoft Studios. You might know them most recently from like the Wasteland series, Wasteland 2, which I have actually on Windows 10, and I need to dive into that. So now, never a better chance. Bard's Tale 4, I think, was one of their most recent titles. So again, super excited to work alongside them and to see what comes next.
13 studios.
It's pretty hefty.
Yeah, it's been with E3 earlier this year and these two. So we've got and you know, those are investments that are going to pay off, you know, in the short term, in the near term, the medium and long term. So it's a long game.
Yeah,
but I don't have to tell you that, Jeffrey.
I'm right here with you, Larry.
I know.
But just in this initial period, it was just great seeing like the Twitter accounts of the different companies and folks like Brian Fargo and a lot, you know, a lot of founders, Fergus Urquhart, like tweeting back and forth, and it's just like there's a nice warm glow. It just feels great.
Right.
Another thing we launched, actually, this is I think the first thing that we launched was there was a new trailer for Crackdown 3. That was really cool. Commander Jackson, you know, going back and forth.
It's Terry versus Terry.
Terry versus Commander. Yeah, like real life Terry versus right, fictional Terry.
Right.
And I laughed. I saw it three or four times. I laughed.
You did laugh.
And of course, that's coming in February 15th and directly into Game Pass. There was a ton of Game Pass here. In fact, we had so many Game Pass games, I think 16 games announced,
yep,
coming into Game Pass that we had to break it up into like four sections.
Including Ori and the Blind Forest.
And Ori and the Will of the Wisps.
When it releases next year.
Yep. The one that jumped out at me, and there's actually a couple. Well, one, I've talked on this show about Mutant Year Zero.
You have been.
And I'm just going to keep talking about it. It comes out in December, so we'll be talking about it again before the end of the year. I cannot wait to try this as a strategy fan, as an XCOM fan. But Void Bastards, I had the honor of announcing that one early on in the show. This is coming from some of the creators of BioShock.
Yes.
And it has, I mean, it looks like a show on Cartoon Network or something that happens to be an FPS, but there's more to it than that. It looks like there's some strategy. It looks like there's a lot going on. I'm going to link out to the Void Bastards trailer because you do need to see it. And
right.
This is something I'm looking forward to. Of course, it's going to debut directly into Game Pass. So if you've got Game Pass now, you're going to have Void Bastards when it launches. And if you don't have it, you can sign up for a buck
right.
or a euro or 10, I think it was 10 pesos.
Right.
Something like that.
Right. Do you want to keep going?
I'm taking a note.
Oh, okay.
Put the trailer in.
Okay.
Let's see. We announced our Black Friday deals. I'm gonna. You have these on MajorNelson.com.
I had so many. I had to paginate the post.
18 times.
18
there are
pages.
18 pages of deals.
Were you surprised by that?
I knew there'd be a lot, but the fact that page one barely gets us into B, it gets us to Batman: Return to Arkham. It's crazy. I don't think I'm exaggerating by much to say. Everything's on sale. Even stuff that has just come out, like Assassin's Creed Odyssey, up to 33% off.
Hey. You're getting dangerously close to Crazy Larry territory.
It's hard to not be crazy. Even Red Dead.
Right.
Red Dead is 10% off if you're a gold member, and Red Dead just came out.
Right. And it is a must-play game. Conversation over.
Absolutely. And I've put in so much time. But everything from Abzu to Zoo Tycoon is
on sale.
Hey, you see what I did there?
Yep.
And then also a ton, I think 5-7 pages of Xbox 360 games, the majority of which I believe are backward compatible. Not quite all of them, but most of them. Maybe.
Quite a few.
Yeah. So I'll link out to the, it's quite an impressive list of Black Friday games. So if there's anything you haven't gotten to, it's all in all likelihood. And by the way, we say Black Friday, it's also Black Thursday and Tuesday and Wednesday, and it's going to go on until let's see, so early access goes through November 18th, so probably while you're listening to it, and there's a number of other deals that are going to be expanding out, but definitely
check it
by
out
by the end of this weekend. You're going to want to check this out because, man, these are incredible deals.
And I also want to point out that, you know, you can go over to the Microsoft store, the digital store. It has a gifting option. So if you're looking for something for that special someone in your life and you want to start gifting like a maniac, we got you covered.
Sure do.
So
speaking of maniacs.
Yes.
No, that's just you.
By the way, I was just thinking of something. We talked earlier about turkeys.
Yeah.
Apparently the new thing is to get mini turkeys. Because people realize that 30-pound turkeys aren't normal, so you may want to look at getting a mini turkey.
But we have 12 people. If I have one mini turkey, people are going
to
think...
Well, you're going to have to get a flock.
Does everyone get their own turkey?
Apparently.
Well, now I got to look into this.
Okay, I'll send you a link.
I do make a pretty good turkey. Then again, it's all about the gravy. You have two things to do. One, don't dry it out.
Right.
Okay. Everyone wants to overcook it, and then it just tastes like garbage. But even if you do overcook them a little bit, gravy will bail you out every time.
Okay.
So I buy a gallon of gravy.
Yeah, right.
And then I'm just like, drench it, put it on the potatoes, put it on everything else.
I've actually seen you take it and just put a straw in it.
Into the gravy? Yeah. I mean, what's wrong with that?
Yes, you don't.
Also, just, you know, drink half and half. What's wrong with it? We talked about Fortune Island coming to Forza Horizon 4.
We did.
As if there wasn't enough content
already.
You
know what it sounds like to me?
Yeah.
That sounds like a gambling destination.
Fortune Island's like Macau or something?
Yeah, or something in Peter Pan.
Yeah. I mean, there was a great image, and I saw someone who worked on the game tweeted out. They're like, I designed that road. So there's like some crazy, like super switchback, you know, mountains that are paved. There's a lot of those would be sort of dirt. Roads in you know, the original Forza Horizon 4. So look, the advances, like what we saw in terms of Storm Island and Blizzard Mountain in previous Forza Horizons, and of course the Hot Wheels pack, like we know that the additions tend to add like a ton, but then also change the gameplay enough to, like, you know, make you want to come back. So that comes out on December 13th. On Xbox One and Windows 10.
As if you didn't have enough to play.
Exactly. Let's see. We saw the arena for Sea of Thieves.
Woohoo!
So
you didn't watch my panel because you weren't there.
I wasn't there.
Yeah, sleeping. That's fine. That's fine.
It was a long night. But yeah, so you talked all. Why don't you tell us all about it then?
No, it's great. It's a brand new. It's kind of a it's a brand new section of the map that you'll use. You can apparently at the top of the menu, kind of like Red Dead or Grand Theft Auto has, where you can go like single player, multiplayer. It'll have two different options. You can go right into the regular version, or you can go into the arena. And it's going to be a quicker PvP kind of experience. So, you know, because the problem with, not the problem, but one of the things with Sea of Thieves is you kind of, when you sit down all of a sudden 3 hours later, right? Maybe you kind of want a 15 or 20 minute experience, and that's what they're going to focus on.
That's good.
On here,
yeah, so. Some of us are busy. Yeah. Don't always have the time. So we talked about the Zed Hunter pack coming to State of Decay. Yep. If you got Game Pass, or if you got State of Decay 2, the Zed Hunter pack will be free. I'm all about this crossbow.
Yep.
You know, it's strong and it's silent.
Yep.
Let's see. We looked at the Void mode for Devil May Cry 5.
Right.
We looked at Jump Force, which showed a pretty crazy trailer. You talked to the lead of Just Cause 4.
Oh,
I'm looking
great.
Forward to that. I mean, there's still games coming.
You never played that game, did you? You never
Just
really
Cause 4?
Yeah, you never got into Just Cause. I got into all of them. I love them.
I played a little bit of 2, I feel like.
It's just ridiculous fun. There's nothing wrong with it.
Kingdom Hearts 3 we talked about. That was the one feedback I got from my wife, because she watched that segment. She was like, that game looks so cute.
Well, I did know. I talked with her. And we were texting. Apparently, her nickname you is Poo. That's what her nickname for you is? Is that true?
You're texting my wife?
Maybe.
When did this happen? When did this start? I mean, I have your wife's number. I need to, like, not in a bad way. But it's more like, hey, does Larry have this?
Yeah.
Maybe we hang out too much, Larry. I'm not sure. We saw The Forge and Shadow of the Tomb Raider. I got to play that.
Yep.
And I mean, I loved Shadow of the Tomb Raider. So some more... some more dungeons and some more tombs, all about that. Xbox One backward compatibility we talked about. Hashimoto-san revealed that Final Fantasy 13, 13-2, and Lightning Returns are all coming to backwards compat, and they're enhanced for Xbox One. I've seen Xbox One X. So I've seen, like on Reddit, a great like comparison of Lightning, like a screenshot, and it's just amazing the detail that was there all along, but now that it's on Xbox One X, you can see, the bottom of her boot head like treads on it.
Right.
And, you know, the hair has a lot more, you know, whatever.
Hair.
I guess so. There's just more fidelity is the word I was looking for.
Yes.
But it's just really cool to see games again for the first time and have it look the way you remember, but like it's really better than you remember.
Yeah.
Oh, mouse and keyboard support was another thing we talked about.
Yes, you and I did that.
We did do that.
We were
and it's coming to a lot of games.
So, P.S., go back and watch that if you get a chance. We're actually standing outside in Phil Spencer's private, like he had a deck because he was doing
interviews.
He was doing interviews with all the local press down there, and he had this little pied-à-terre.
Pied-à-terre. That's very good.
So
speaking, we've heard your French now, but you know what? I heard a lot of your Spanish.
Oh,
in
we're
Mexico.
Not
going to
bring that. Are we going to? No,
we are going to bring this up because
okay.
I've given you a hard time before that every time I go to Gamescom, you improbably strike up an Italian accent.
I can't. Well, when you order an espresso, I can't help but say espresso. Right,
so we go to breakfast.
We go to breakfast like we do.
And no surprise.
Yes.
They ask what you want to drink. I'm like, I'll have a coffee.
Yep.
And you order an espresso.
I did.
Good tongue rolling.
Yep.
Of course, the waiter just says, oh, espresso? Okay.
Yeah.
And
I don't know where this came from.
Why don't you tell us what your entree was?
All I said was, you know, Jeff, you ordered the...
I ordered the huevos a la cubana.
Which looked great.
It was really
good. And I don't know why, but he asked me what I wanted, and I was in the mood for waffles.
Waffle. Now,
I've never pronounced waffles with a waffle. I don't know where it came from.
I could almost give you a pass on the espresso. but waffle? There's no H in waffle.
No, there's nothing like that.
I believe they're from Belgium, where that would not be the pronunciation either way. And I just put my menu down. Like, I just didn't even know what to say.
Right.
And you knew it as soon as you said it.
Right.
So, Larry, international man of mystery.
Waffles.
And
they were good.
Well, they were good. Later that day, they're warming up the crowd. We're getting ready. We have a lot of folks
there. Right before the show.
And we had someone there named Juan Carlo who was, you know, speaking Spanish, letting them know what was going to be happening as we were recording, you know, on stage. And, you know, he made eye contact with you and you were like, yeah, I'll go up
Juan
there.
Juan Carlos was fantastic.
He's a leader among men.
Yes.
And... I'm like, Larry doesn't know Spanish. What is he going to say?
Right.
And he picks up the phone. I start recording. He just said, Hola, Mexico.
And that's all I need to say.
And then you put the mic right back down. Dying. I thought you were going to launch into something else. And then...
Sometimes less is more, Jeffrey.
Less was more. You know what? Everyone was welcoming. Everything was great. Yeah. So I think we'll just round it up by saying the Xbox fans in Mexico are just amazing. They made us feel really welcome.
World class.
And thank you for everything. A good feeling. It's still, even a week later, still feeling great about it.
That's true.
I'm just wrapping it up.
Yeah, that's true. We had a nice walk through Mexico City as well.
Yeah.
With Julia.
We did. Julia Hardy.
Yeah.
BBC One's Julia
I got spotted,
Hardy.
By the way. I went back to that shopping center to pick up some things for my family. And when I was going down the escalator, Major Nelson. So nice. It was lovely.
People know the Major.
Nah, I don't know about that.
They know when Xbox. We were checking into the hotel, they were like, there's a reason I was on floor 6 and you were on floor 29 or something.
You didn't have 4 bedrooms?
That's fine.
You didn't have a swimming pool in your room? Wow. Okay.
The jacuzzi. So... it's been a very eventful week. There's actually a lot to talk about here. Something that took place this week, the November 2018 Xbox update has rolled out.
Yes.
So the mouse and keyboard support, we talked about it, and a couple days later, it's real.
There it is.
There it is.
Ta-da.
So you can, of course, plug in, USB mice or keyboards. Of course, whether or not the game will support it is dependent on the developer.
Yeah, let's be very clear. It's not like you plug it in and all of a sudden you're playing Halo with a mouse and keyboard.
And that it's something that takes thought because you need to balance, certain games that are, especially competitive shooters, you want to make sure mouse and keyboard people are playing against mouse and keyboard people. Yep. And that's what they're doing.
Yep.
So you don't have to worry. We don't want to hear that if, someone owns you with like a headshot across the map, don't say, oh, that was a mouse and keyboard person. No, they're just really good on the sticks.
It doesn't work like that.
Yeah. So, and I am looking forward to seeing what Razer's going to come up with. They're going to be talking more.
We had Minley on the show.
We did. Yeah. And so there's going to be some design for Xbox mice and keyboards. I think they said they were going to talk more at CES?
I believe so, CES 2019.
So that's always early January, and those are things I'm going to want to get a hold of.
I have not been in years.
I have not been. Yeah, it's been about 5 years.
Yeah, I think that's about right.
By
the way. Yeah. I'm sorry. Could we just pause for a moment
for station identification on Major Nelson Radio Network?
We need to wish you a happy, hearty congratulations on 5 years at Microsoft.
5 years? Can you believe it?
I can believe it. It seems like just yesterday you started.
It really does.
And even though we've known each other for how long is 11
more
years?
Than 2006.
Yeah,
12 years.
12 years. Yeah, so.
Oh my God. Anyway. No. Yeah. 2007.
Something like that.
We met at World Cyber Games 2017
down in Orlando. Lovely, lovely,
lovely Orlando, Florida
at Universal Studios.
Yes.
It's my last time on the Universal Studios Resort before I got walked off many years ago.
Wait, what?
It's a long story.
Were you escorted away
Oh, I was.
Is this a story you can tell?
No, not right now. It's not what we're talking about.
All right.
But anyway.
Was there a don't you know who I am?
This is before I worked at Microsoft or worked at Xbox. Okay. This is way back.
Got it.
A long time
All right.
ago.
Well, you had nothing to leverage.
No.
So one of the cool things in this update is the expansion of the Xbox skill for Cortana and Alexa.
Yeah.
I actually went ahead and I finally paired this and did this. I was at home yesterday morning. I was like, you know what? I'm going to add this. And it's pretty cool to say, hey, Alexa, tell Xbox to turn on. And then it works. There's a ton of different skills. Where's the best place to find all of those different commands?
I think you just say, what can I say?
What can I say?
Yeah.
So, but it's really easy to set up. You can basically go into devices and you'll see one that says voice assistance and you just have to check the box basically.
Check the box.
And then after that, you go into the Alexa app that you may have on your phone that connects with your existing Dot or Spot or whatever it is that you got. And I was up and running in a minute. 90 seconds. It was and then you signed in and that was that. So that was pretty cool. The Amazon Music app is coming to Xbox One. More search. There's a bunch more stuff. I will link out to the Xbox Insider blog that has all of the latest releases.
You know what I'm currently fascinated with right now?
Hmm.
Completely random.
Waffles?
The Mandarin Duck.
The one that was in Central Park?
Yeah.
Did they find it again?
Oh, yeah, he's there. He's playing around. I'm just looking. He's playing around in the snow right now.
What do you have, like a live view of the Mandarin duck?
I don't know. There's so many people in New York that every time he shows up, people just take pictures of this beautiful duck.
Where did the duck come from?
That's the big question.
I mean, it's from Mandarin from China?
It's from China?
I don't know how to say somewhere
in Asia. So
okay. It's a beautiful duck.
He got off in JFK and just took the train right into the city. So I don't know what else to tell you.
It's the crosswords of the world, right?
As you and I know.
Yes.
Continuing on with the news and the randomness.
Yeah. All right. Couple free. You know me. I like the free.
Who doesn't?
So a couple free weekends are coming up if you have Xbox Live Gold. So one of them is the NBA 2K19 is going to be free this weekend. This very weekend's already started. And it'll be going through, I believe, Sunday night.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's a good chance to play Jimmy Buckets now on the Sixers.
Yep.
I love NBA 2K. It's a great game and it's free. If you haven't tried it out, it's great for couch co-op or couch competitive. I mean, you can do it either way.
Yep.
Always. I still like talking smack. Online, I getting beat by people I never met. That's fine. Might be, you know, if you're competitive,
you've done that.
Good.
You know what it feels like.
But, you know, beating my brother to a pulp, there's just something that's just amazing.
You know, we never did
our... Do we not do our annual Madden game?
We did
game?
Not do our annual Madden game. I don't know what happened.
Are you sure?
I'm 1,000%.
Why don't we do it over Thanksgiving? It's a Thanksgiving Day game.
Could we?
We could do it.
We could.
Because these mini turkeys you're setting me up for, they only take an hour to cook.
Yeah, you're going to have to cook a dozen.
Oh, that's true. I'm going to have to buy a heat lamp. But no, we should definitely do that.
I don't want
to
have any turkey waste from you.
Well,
it's a big deal.
We compost in Seattle.
Right.
So there's really no waste. It all just goes back into the environment.
Oh, there's the duck again. Sorry, I'm watching this feed and there's the ducks.
So. Why don't we link out to the man?
No,
beautiful, just so you see what we're talking about.
Well, if you've never seen him, this is a stunning.
It is. It's poultry. Well, and it disappeared last week. That's how I first became aware of it.
What do you mean
it
disappeared last week? Oh, you weren't aware of him before?
I didn't know there was a...
Oh, yeah. I have some friends in New York that were tweeting this, and it was like all the rage down there.
I guess it had disappeared for a little bit.
Wonder
where it came back. And here's a story on CBS News. Rare Mandarin duck reappears. I'm a little worried about it at Thanksgiving because it is a lovely fowl.
It is a stunning bird.
Duck's delicious. So
leave
that one alone.
Wow.
Well, look.
Wait a minute. So if we're talking about small turkeys, they're going to basically be the size of ducks.
Well, have you ever had a turducken?
No.
You've never had a turducken?
That was always E's thing. I never got into that.
Well, I mean, I always thought that was like a John Madden thing because I'd never heard of it, but until whenever he started talking about it. It's pretty good.
Okay.
For those who don't know, and I'd imagine everyone knows, it's a turkey stuffed with, no, not stuffing, a duck,
mm-hmm.
which is then stuffed with a chicken. So you have three layers of meaty goodness. And then you sort of, each bite you slice through it, you get a little bit of everything.
And if you're listening to us outside the United States, now you know what's going on over here.
They have these birds in other... Turkey, I feel like, is pretty rare outside of the U.S.
Yeah.
And probably Canada.
Certainly chicken.
But duck is pretty popular. Yeah. Chicken, everyone loves a chicken. Mm-hmm. So the other free game, free trial, that's going to be starting actually November 20th, so sort of middle of next week, Overwatch. And I bring it up. We haven't played in a while, but Ash is now part of the game. That patch has gone live.
Yeah.
I'm hearing, you know, there was a big release, I think, about a week and a half ago when she was announced, and now she's out with Bob, who is like her old, who I hear is like a real game changer. We need to get back into that.
Yeah, you've been playing Fortnite.
I have been playing a lot of Fortnite.
I've noticed.
I feel like after season six, maybe I'll take a break.
Okay.
But we've been all about it, like, you know.
I understand.
I mean, it's a popular game. I don't know
Everyone's
if you know, but a few
it.
People are playing
There's
it.
There's quite a few people playing
and they keep it. They keep it fresh. They do. Yeah, right now there's sort of like a, you know, tomato versus hamburger thing happening. Pizza versus hamburgers.
Okay.
It's a new mode. Like every week I tune in, there's a new mode. So,
right.
Kudos to them.
Yep.
Anyway,
keep going.
Anyway, so yeah, free Overwatch starting November 20th. If you've got Xbox Live Gold, go for it. And
Do
also
it.
This weekend, and obviously this won't cost you anything, you can watch the Halo Championship Series final at DreamHack Atlanta. So that will be you can just tune in. It's not going to be hard to find that across anything, but if you want to follow at HCS for Halo Championship Series at Twitter, of course, you can just follow at Halo. You probably already are following them, and you'll be able to see everything that's going on there. But it'll be on Mixer. It'll be on Twitch. It'll be on YouTube.
Mm-hmm.
If they show videos online, you're going to be able to watch it, and it'd be cool to watch it.
Yeah.
Halo 5, watching people on the competitive level play Halo 5 is pretty awesome. And there's going to be some Halo 3
humbling.
2v2 stuff.
Yeah.
Which is cool.
Yeah.
And then this was a big, This was a big release week.
Yeah. Wow, was it ever?
It sure was. Two major, major games. Battlefield 5,
right.
Now available on Xbox One. Of course, if you had EA Access, you might have been playing for a week already.
Yep.
And Fallout 76, which you went all the way to West Virginia for.
I did.
Fallout 76 is now available, including the Tricentennial Edition. I gotta find time for these games.
Why aren't you playing?
Because I'm playing everything.
Yeah. Without spoilers, how far are you in Red Dead?
I'm 37%.
Okay.
It does give you percentage every time you save it. I don't know how I could tell you without spoilers, so I'm not going to, or I'll tell you off camera, but you're definitely still further ahead than I am.
Right.
Right?
Yeah.
I think you are.
44, 45%.
Okay. And I'm doing, like, honestly, I'm doing every side mission.
Yeah, I mean, I'm now going back now that what I tend to do is I tend to power through a game like this, which is so complicated, not complicated, but there's just so much
to do. There's so much to do.
And then I'm like, okay, now I get how this works. And I go back and start doing some of the earlier things now that I kind of understand what's going on and how to do them.
One of the cool things about this game is that it's not like you go to the map and there's 7,000 icons there and you're like, oh my God, I'm paralyzed by choice.
Right.
It's more like, oh, there's one, maybe two. Right. Missions on the map, but then as you're going there, something else
encounters.
Will pop up. You'll have exactly what Somebody appears to be a random encounter, and that might lead to a whole thread of other things to do.
Right.
And so if you keep your mind open, you end up, you know, with a lot of things. There's a lot of things to keep in mind. So, for instance, one of the characters is a child, and at one point he mentioned, you know, he left his book behind, and then I was just in a random house, and I ended up finding...
You found the book?
I found the book.
That's the one I'm looking for.
Okay. I'll have to show you where I found it in an abandoned house in Lemoyne.
Okay.
Right before I got killed, but fortunately I kept the book, and I brought it back, and it just felt real good to give him that
Make
book.
Make him happy.
Yeah. And then he gave me something.
That's funny because I did one and somebody, I got something for somebody and they said, oh, there's now a present for you in your room. And my room was such a mess, I couldn't find it.
Someone left me pomade, so I don't know.
That was me.
You know what? Mexican water made my hair look great.
You know,
I got two or three compliments.
You know what? I'm going to say this. Dare I say, Brian Crescente great.
Let's not go that far. The man has tresses.
It sure does.
I'm just happy to have mostly full coverage. Another game came out this week that I'm hearing really good stuff about.
Yes.
Hitman 2.
Yeah.
So
that's another one.
I've seen a number of reviews that said this was maybe the best Hitman.
Right.
So Hitman 2 is now available on Xbox One. Here's one we talked about on the show. As debuting in a Game Pass, Thief of Thieves.
Yeah.
Season 1.
We talked about that.
Thing that's interesting about this. Not that it sounds like Sea of Thieves if you talk too quickly. So it's a comic book sort of design, but it's by Robert Kirkman, who, of course, you're going to know from The Walking Dead.
Walking Dead, yeah.
So that is enough to make me want to try it. And of course, if it's part of Game Pass, well, I mean, I already have it, right?
Right.
And then we already mentioned that...
What, you don't have it? Then you should get it.
You should get it.
Just put down a buck.
The first month.
$1.
He acted that out.
I did.
It was good. And then... Like we mentioned, Ted Price was up here, and one of his first games was Spyro.
Yeah.
Back in the day, early days of Insomniac in like the 90s, right? Mm-hmm. Was it the late 90s?
He's been around.
Yeah. I think their first game was Disruptor, which was like a PS1 shooter.
Right.
That's a bit of arcane trivia for you. Anyway, Spyro Reignited Trilogy, which is like a remastered Spyro 2, Riptor's Rage, and Year of the Dragon, all remastered. For about $40 available on Xbox One. Oh, and one last thing I wanted to mention. Actually, well, maybe two.
You've got a few more things.
There's a couple. I saw the Just Dance 2019 demo is available for free.
I'll tell Laura.
And
that
made me think, well, yes, for her, after you've had your mini turkey and you're feeling all carbed out, you got the itis and you're dozing on the couch, you know, maybe you get up and you play a little bit of Just Dance and then, you know, you work off some of that or you do the turkey trot. You ever did the turkey trot? It was a huge mistake I made last year. There's a lot of places, there's this race called a turkey trot. And it's not super competitive. It's like a 5K. The one in Seattle's almost all downhill, thank God. And we did it, but in typical Seattle November fashion, it was raining and it was cold.
Mm-hmm.
And why did I do that? Mm-hmm. I don't know. So probably
did
not
it,
doing the turkey
did it
trot
end,
this
did
year.
Did it end at Top Pot?
It wouldn't, Top Pot would have been closed. That would have been good though.
Right.
Well, anyway, so maybe this year I do a little,
you'll need to do any of it because you'll be having a micro turkey.
A svelte micro turkey.
You're going to have a McTurkey.
I'm going to, Well, you laugh, but I bet there's probably someplace. McDonald's always alters to the local the yes. local market.
Yes.
I've had some chicken in Japan there.
I have a friend of mine who did PR for McDonald's for a long time.
Really?
He's told me some wild stories about the local market stuff and what they do and so forth. So
I remember one year I was in Japan, they had like a squid ink, like a black
right.
bun burger. Yeah, crazy. And everyone was going crazy for it.
Mm-hmm.
I like, you know, do you like the squid ink, Larry? I feel like it's not your speed.
It writes very well, very smooth.
Mm, that's good. Yeah. Right off a, you know, your malt block.
When I'm, writing checks with a feathered pen.
You write so rarely. When we were going into Mexico, you know, you have to fill out a
You didn't have
thing.
A pen. You had to borrow mine.
I had to borrow a pen. And even then, I'm like, no one's going to be able to read this. It was just, I was like, this is the first time I've written anything in weeks.
Right.
It's bad.
Since you checked that guilty box for the speeding ticket.
I did that digitally, by the way. How did you know that? Did my wife tell you that when you're doing your weekly gab sesh?
Yes.
The last thing, I don't know where this is going, that I thought was really interesting is I saw on your blog, themajornelson.com, Onimusha Warlords is now available for digital pre-order and pre-download. Yeah. Onimusha was like you know, I think that the original Genma Onimusha, which was sort of a variety of this game, was on the OG Xbox, which again, 17 years, it all comes full circle. So this one is an enhanced version of that best-selling adventure classic. I loved the Onimusha series. At the time, it looked amazing.
That's what the copy says right here.
That's exactly what I'm reading. And so it comes out early January, and it's only $20. So I'll probably be checking it out.
Yep.
Assuming I've finished Just Cause, Assassin's Creed, Red Dead, what else? Fallout 76.
Wow.
And
the list goes on.
And Battlefield 5. That's it. That's it. I don't have a lot to play.
I have so much to play.
One last thing I want to bring up, just as a congratulations to folks that are heck in this building and building right next to us, Time Magazine.
That's the one with the red border.
The one with the red border. It's made out of paper. There's a number of pages in it. It's new. Mm-hmm. Best Inventions 2018. And who's on there? What's on there? The Xbox Adaptive Controller.
Yay.
So, you know, congratulations to all the folks who put that together. You know, it's just amazing how it's been able to, you know, just the thought of bringing gaming to people that maybe had not been able to experience it or had not been able to experience it in a way that was as effective or as easy, I guess, as they would have liked, that this has been able to empower that. I think that's really awesome. I've gotten to work with a number of creators who we got the controller to, and I've gotten a lot of great feedback. So congrats to the team making that.
Yeah.
And, you know, that's all I got to say about that.
That's all. It's great. Great. If you know, it makes a big difference to somebody who needs it.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of people out there that need this thing, and it helps them. More people gaming. You know, it was great to spend time down in Mexico with Phil. Phil and I had a great conversation about the adaptive controller and the mouse and keyboard support and all that. So we got some good stuff coming, don't we, Jeffrey?
You really want to get a headline here, Larry.
Well, no. I also want to point out, you talked about the Black Friday deals. There's also a series of Black Friday deals for hardware. So if you're interested in maybe upgrading your Xbox One to the Xbox One X, the most powerful console, and playing a little bit of Red Dead, well,
never been cheaper.
This now is the time. So that's. I just want to make sure I point that
out. Not only that, and this is probably worth mentioning, is a lot of the TVs, we partner a lot with Samsung. I happen to have... Well, I got a second Samsung, one for the living room. I had one for the gaming room.
And that's in addition to the one you have in the bathroom.
No, that's my sacred space.
Right.
Larry.
Right.
Yeah. So I feel like they're a good pairing. Mm-hmm. So I got one of the QLEDs and I love it.
QLED.
Yep. And, I'm one of these people that said NES, not, you know, NES. So
really?
Maybe, I think you could say QLED, right?
GIF or GIF?
They got my money. GIF. I'm a GIFman.
Okay.
So I know that's probably wrong. Anyway, point is, those TVs are, they've literally never been lower priced. These like 4K proper HDR10 compatibility with like 120 hertz refresh rate and up. So it pairs very well, obviously, with the X. And it's just amazing, just in the past, since the X came out a year ago, how the fidelity of my gaming has
increased dramatically.
It really has.
It has. Well, yeah, so I just want to give you guys an update. We wanted to jump into the studio because we hadn't done a show in a while, so we're going
to
wrap
things. Want to do the waffle.
Waffle. The waffle story. Thank you for that.
Coca Light.
Now, we're going to do a, we're not here next week because we have the holiday, the U.S. holiday. We talked about Thanksgiving, but the following week, we're going to go back into the TV studio and do a Mixer podcast.
Mixer, Studio One.
And I've got some, we did the game show last time, remember?
We did. Should we
do
that again?
We may do that again.
I thought that was really fun.
Yeah, we it was a beta test and we got a bunch of feedback and the engineers enjoyed it and they're making some changes. So we got a bunch of stuff. So that'll be probably, I don't know, the exact date, probably be maybe like the 28th or the 29th of November.
Couple of weeks.
I'll let you guys know when it's going to happen because we're going to go back in the studio, you and me. We'll have a special guest or two. We'll have some stuff to show off or two. And
really?
We'll give some stuff away.
Ooh, so. Oh, I have something I want to show. Okay, we'll save it.
Sure?
We'll save it.
Okay, yeah. All right. You sure?
No. Well, this is an audio podcast. Yeah, I can't show
that's
it now.
Right. Oh, that's very nice. All right. Well, we're gonna wrap things up so you guys can get back to your Red Dead or Battlefield or
Fallout
or whatever you're playing because there's so much right now.
So much.
So if you want to hit Jeff up on social media, follow him at?
At Jeff Rubenstein.
Follow me at Major Nelson. And of course, MajorNelson.com for all your sales and information needs.
And Mandarin Duck.
And Mandarin Duck updates.
Yeah.
All right. We'll talk to you guys in a couple weeks. Right, Jeff?
Happy Thanksgiving.
Ta-ta.